My name is Annabel Tyndale. I'm an acupuncturist and I graduated from NCA in 2015. And studying at the NCA was a really enjoyable experience for me. I'd previously been to a much larger university, so this was on a small scale, which I really enjoyed. But most importantly, the learning experience is unique. I'd recommend studying at the NCA because of the small scale environment and the support you receive. For me, I think it was my favourite educational experience throughout my life, and I wouldn't hesitate to recommend it. After graduating, I was very fortunate to have the opportunity to work alongside another acupuncturist. So in the summer months, before I got my licence, I observed in clinics both in Scunthorpe and Lincoln to get to know patients, how the clinic worked. It was great, it was a real valuable experience for me, having that opportunity and being able to get to know people. And then once I got my licence in September, I was able to get straight to work with an already established client base. Setting up practice was quite quick for me, again because I worked alongside an already established acupuncturist. I didn't have the responsibility of finding a space or taking out the lease, buying supplies, that kind of thing. So I felt like I could really concentrate on growing as a practitioner, yet having that support there if I wanted to. I share a working space with a reflexologist. So for me, I've kind of got the best of both worlds now. I get to work alongside somebody else in Scunthorpe, but here in Lincoln, I feel like I'm really getting a rounded view of what it's like in both scenarios. There are pros and cons to how I operate. I'm really grateful and thankful for the opportunity to work alongside an established acupuncturist. I think in that first year of practice, it really helped me grow and develop as a practitioner. I suppose one of the disadvantages is I work in two different towns, so 40-45 minutes apart. Being your own boss is great, but it's not without challenge. For me, the biggest challenge is discipline. I think I could do something acupuncture related every single day of the week, whether it's accounts, seeing patients, research, and I think it's really important when you're your own boss to be able to step aside and actually make some time for you. I do think maybe people think self-employment is a bed of roses, and I'm not saying it isn't without reward, but it is a lot of hard work, and even things like holidays, you sort of have to plan well in advance to make sure that you cover that time off, etc. But I definitely recommend being your own boss. You don't have to answer to anyone. Because I work in an established clinic, I've been very fortunate that it's already got a client base. I have worked to recruit more patients. It's thinking of inventive ways to try and encourage people to try acupuncture. In terms of marketing, I've tried a few different things. I've done some leafleting where I've gone around hairdressers, beauty spas, delis, health food shops, gift shops, wherever I would spend a few minutes talking about acupuncture and kind of displaying my leaflets. I've also taken part in some talks and events, had stands at sort of complementary therapy fairs, that kind of thing, and also social media. I think really it's just about letting people know that you're here and what you can offer. People tend to think it's like, oh, I've got to hard sell, but it really is just about, educating people on why they might have acupuncture. To new graduates, I'd say be prepared to work hard. It is difficult setting up a business, but that doesn't mean to say that it's not rewarding. Being an acupuncturist was the best decision I've made, I believe, and so I'd say, go for it.